to be sleeve splashes. Okay, this is a representation of your sleeve. I just made it small so it should fit in my camera. So let's pretend that this is the front side and this is the back side. The check mark is the right side of your fabric, and the cross mark is the wrong side of your fabric. Now, we're going to make a line at the half back part of your sleeve. So what you're going to do is fold it, mark, and then fold it again and draw a line. And then fold it again and draw a line. We're going to put our underlap and overlap here. Okay, this is your underlap and this is your overlap. The measurement is indicated in your module. So it will be easier for you to manipulate it. Okay, after stitching the corner, we're going to cut the center line. And then about half an inch before the end, we're going to cut diagonally towards the corner. Okay, you have to cut exactly above the line, below the line. Okay, but try to be careful not to cut the stitches because you have, if by accident you cut the stitch, you have to repeat everything. Try to skip the corner as far as you can so you'll have a nice finish. Next, what you're going to do is you're going to flip up the triangle and then just try to finger press it. Okay, so it will be flat. Now we're going to turn everything under. We're going to turn this around. Try to finger press this or use a hot steam press. Do the same thing for the other side. Press this using your fingernails. And we're going to turn everything on the wrong side. Okay, next we're going to turn everything underneath. So we're facing the wrong side. Turn around your underlap. So on the folded side, we're going to cover the seam allowance. Okay. And then pin it. And then we're going to stitch this later. So pin everything. And we're going to do the same thing with the overlap. So turn it around. And then we're going to cover the seam allowance as well. Okay, next we're going to edge stitch the underlap. This is the right side of the fabric. I turn it around and then we're going to stitch 1/16 away from the very edge. So you're going to stitch at the very end of the corner. Okay, now after sewing the underlap, we're going to sew the overlap. Okay, the position of the triangle should be inside here and then the underlap should be over the triangle, so when you turn it around, it should have a clean finish. Okay? And then what we're going to do is we're going to fold the top into a nice triangular shape. So first, fold a 45 degree. Fold the fabric 45 degree and then fold it again on the 45 degree. So, and then lay it flat. You have to have a nice, even triangle shape. So try to adjust to get that nice triangle shape and then pin. Pin everything so it won't move. Now we're going to do a top stitch here to seal off our placket. So we're going to try to locate the underlap. So I think it's here. We have to hit the underlap and the triangle. So I'm just going to position my pin here. So what we're going to do is stitch starting from here, going towards here, and then we're going to outline the triangle shape and then finish everything by going down to the underlap. Okay, next we're going to put pleats on the bigger part of the sleeve. So from the overlap, try to mark half an inch markings. This will be our guide for the pleats. Okay, next what you're going to do is just fold the pleats. Okay, we need one more. Okay, if your cuffs is bigger than your sleeves, try to put some more pleats so it would fit your cuffs. Then put a safe stitch so your pleats will be in place for later when we attach the cuffs to the sleeves.